Hey guys, welcome back. My name is April Payne, founder of April Miller Coaching, where I focus on empowering others to be the leaders they are meant to be. I've been discussing various parts of how to empower and develop leadership within yourself. If you missed out, I have three links below where you can catch up on part one, part two, and part three. Today, I will be discussing how to develop self-empowerment by using trust. Trust is something that is carefully developed and learned, but yet very easily broken. But let's dive in. So first off, trust can take time and can be difficult most of the time. However, there are five things you can do to make it easier and have it take less time. So the first one is to be open. When you share information, your ideas, your thoughts, think about also sharing your emotions, feelings, and your honest reactions. Don't be fake. I mean, don't, because people can see right through it and then they shy away really quickly. When someone else shows their own emotions, feelings, and reactions, then you need to also respond appropriately and react appropriately, because that can develop that trust. The second tip is to share and cooperate. If you find some great resources and you have a lot of knowledge about something, share it. Share it in order to help others reach their goals. If someone's needing assistance and you have that knowledge and some extra resources, don't hold it back. Work together to help develop those goals. Tip three is to be trustworthy. When others place their trust in you, make sure that you're providing that positive outcome. Tip four is to be accepting. Hold other people's values and views in high respect. What does this do? Well, it makes them feel good and it makes them feel valued. And then that leads itself to trust. And the last tip is to be supportive. Support others when you can, but also recognize their strengths. Give them independence. Allow them to reach their goals as much as they can by themselves. Be supportive. Don't hold their hand. Those are the five things that you can do right now to help develop trust. In the workplace and any professional relationship, though, there are additional tips to establish the trust, because it's just a little bit different environment. So I've given you three more. So with your workplace and professional relationships, first of all, you want to work on integrity and goodwill. You want to trust in your coworkers and your workers if you're higher up on that ladder. It doesn't matter what salary they're making. It doesn't matter how much experience they have or if they're a volunteer or if they're not. Trust in them. The second tip is to have the same goals and trust that every worker has the same end goal in mind and work with that. And the last one is professionalism. Trust in others' competence. Do what you promise them you will do. Speaking from experience, I can tell you that these three things are vital to any organization. I have worked in places where this was not valued. It was very clear and it was horrible. It was a horrible experience. Of course, I'm no longer working there now. Fortunately, I am now in a better place, and it's very clear that these three things are valued. And because of that, I'm at a place where I feel comfortable, relaxed, and in a great mood every day. So I hope these tips have helped you. Try some of them today. In fact, share with me in the comments areas where you think you could do better. Is it being acceptive and supportive? Because I know that's a difficult one for me. Or is it developing integrity or valuing other people's values and, I don't know, being professional? Maybe it's hard to trust another's competence for you, and that's okay. Find an area that you think that you need to work on, share it below, and embrace the positive. Have a great day.